Well, why is Haydn so important for me in the Auflösung? I suppose because he's brilliant. He was considered brilliant back then, in the 18th century. So brilliant, as a matter of fact, that a group of Masonic bigwigs in Paris invited him to create these Paris symphonies.
It was written for the Paris audience, and Haydn knew the renovation in the bow making in France, for example. And I'm sure that he considers this and integrates into his writing.
I chose to do the Paris symphonies because we're in Paris. and my outfit, the Auflösung, is a Parisian ensemble.
Especially in that particular symphony, it makes so Parisian the opening. The opening is so brilliant and so, yeah, very joyful, and the color of the A major. I mean, it's kind of similar to the Paris Symphony written by Mozart, though it's in D major, and that has timpani and trumpets. And in this symphony, there's no timpani, no trumpets, but you could nearly hear them at the very beginning, the opening.
I think Haydn and Mozart was someone like Handel. You could call them humanists, with everything that means, in a very positive way. They're concerned about the human condition. They're concerned about what man can do as well, the good aspects of humanism. What is their message? I think the message is one of contentment, joy, but also passion and emotion.
Just listen it with open-mindedness, with big ears, and Haydn tells just with his own language all the things he wants to tell. So many times Haydn is very witty. There are moments where he stops just the music, and you know the audience just think, what happened? The music has stopped, and then all of a sudden he continues again. For example, all this, you don't have to be prepared to understand this kind of wit.
Why are we still in love with the Italian Renaissance? Why do we still love Watteau? Why do we still love Molière? Or why do we still love composers who have been dead now for so many years? It's the same and always the same reason. They give us hope. They give us the idea that, yes, mankind can be destructive and disruptive, mean and terrible, but man can also rise to extraordinary heights of, and they're the people that we remember, and they're people that we use, and people that essentially keep me going and keep lots of other people going.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.